Hello guys, it's Basic Mystery 3 with the continuation of the Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep Let's Play. Now, a lot of you guys have been recommending me to actually start with Terra's Let's Play before I go into Ventus. However, there are also a lot of you people who say it's perfectly fine for me to start with Ventus as long as I don't start with Aqua, apparently. And then there's those assholes who are saying Aqua's best recommended to start, but I don't fucking know. And then there are people that are saying that one story spoils another story, but that story also spoils another story, and that story spoils the first story. And it's like, oh my god, this is just a complete huge mess. So here's my idea right now, and hopefully it's a good idea because I'm not sure exactly how the save structure is. Like, if you complete one story, if the game, the information of that game stores that information or not. But my idea is that I will switch characters from time to time throughout the entire Let's Play. I will not be doing one playthrough for the entire section. No, I'll be switching characters from one playthrough, and then, like, I'll say, like, for now, I'm probably gonna start as Terra, and then afterwards, I'll start as Ventus in the next recording session, and then the recording session after that, I'm gonna start as Aqua. If that sounds good, then I will definitely be all for it with that, because that seems like the best explanation as to how to properly, even though I really don't give a shit about the story, how to properly adjust to the story, I guess, and to understand it fully without all the spoilers or whatever. It seems that, I don't know, like, what's his face's name again? Terra's story still spoils, I think, part of Ventus or Aqua's story. I don't know, but I kind of want to do this experiment to see what's like. So, last time we left off, we were at Ventus' story in Cinderella's level, but we won't be continuing through that. Right now, we'll be playing through Terra's story in this play session. Next time, we'll probably continue through Ventus, or maybe we'll play as Aqua, depending on the situation. For now, let's just try this experiment out to see what's up. I also got a stopwatch with me right now, finally, because of the copyright claim I have, the copyright strike I have right now. I'm only limited to 15 minutes, which is why there were some parts that were over 15 minutes, and they were on my second channel, my second backup channel, because of that. The first four videos were already uploaded before I got the strike, but because I was unexpected that I would get the strike, I had to upload those other two parts alongside with all the other videos as well in a separate part. So that's one of my... Did I accidentally, like, autosave in the wrong area? Or something? This might not... Okay, no, never mind. Alright. Okay, so yeah, we're going with Terra's story now, I guess. So let's do that. Yeah, because it says nothing. Like, even the game is confusing us as well, because it said nothing about, like, which story. Even though Terra is the first option, technically speaking, it's... I don't know. Like, it's still, like, they should have really clarified it, just in case. But whatever. Let's play as Terra to see what's up. Not only that, but we really didn't get much of Terra's gameplay aesthetics as well, so I guess this could be a good way to, try and get the feel for the character. Not only that, but this is also good for me to preparing for the playthrough sessions of every single character as well, just in case, so that I could properly play as one character and the other character. We technically already saw this cutscene, but I'm gonna see if there's anything different. Like, if it looks like it's the exact same cutscene, then I'm just gonna guess that, assume that we're gonna play as Terra and fight against Aqua. That's my guess. Or maybe we're just gonna battle against those heartless fucks again, as they invade the Colosseum or whatever. Oh, never mind, they are invading the Colosseum. Okay, so yeah, screw Terra and Aqua's fight session. Let's fight these orbs of light. Alright. Hopefully I can remember how to play the game. Wow, Terra is pretty slow. He has a good dash dance, that's good. Alright. God damn. Alright. What was sliding dash? Alright. Okay, so that's a good go into the attack, I guess. Alright. Okay. Finish? Now again, I'm not sure if the game actually stores the data of whether or not you actually completed one story over there. What the fuck? Why is the control so... Why is it inverted again? What the hell? I didn't change that. I'm guessing I have to... Maybe it's just... I have to actually go into an area or something before I switch, because for some reason the X-axis is changed again for some reason. I don't know why. It's been 5 minutes, so we're good to go. I'm really paying attention to stopwatch, unfortunately, so I really can't like focus a whole lot about the game. Especially like if I'm invested in it, that's gonna be even more fucked because that's gonna suck up a lot of my like playthrough sessions. Alright, this looks like a different cutscene.
So what does that matter?
So this looks like it's part of Terra's point of view.
I know I'm strong enough to hold it back.
Yes. You are indeed strong. The darkness is nothing to fear.
Master Xehanort.
And yet, how frustrating that Ericus refutes its power. Why, you could train with him forever, and still, you'd never be a master in his eyes.
The voice actor kind of sounds like he's gargling his voice.
Master Xehanort, what is it that I failed to learn?
I mean, without the subtitles, I probably wouldn't even understand if what he's saying.
You are. If I cannot be destroyed, it can only be channeled.
I guess his voice is very menacing and such, but it's kind of hard distinguish it. Thank God for the subtitles, at least. So this guy, Xehanort, is performing some sort of evil scheme, I presume, using Terra as his pawn. At least that's what I'm gonna guess in terms of the story. Probably not gonna pay attention to it much often, so I don't know why I'm even worried about which character I should play first or whatever, but if you guys really, really want me to do a certain thing, then I should, just in case.
Why isn't Ven here?
Just to be safe,
then,
sorry.
Very well, then. I will send my pupils to investigate. Yes, I understand. Farewell.
Is that what God talking to him?
That was my dear old friend Yen Sid. As you know, he is master no more, but he still keeps a close eye on the tides of light and darkness. His counsel serves as signposts on the road we wielders of the Keyblade must walk. All the more reason then for concern, for he tells me the princesses of heart are in danger. Not only from the forces of darkness, as you may assume, but also from a new threat, one that feeds on negativity. Fledgling emotions that have taken monster form. Yen Sid calls them the Unversed.
And yet, this wasn't explained during Ventus's story. Fuck.
Was striking down any who would upset the
again, why do they give you the option when it's mandatory for one character over the other? It makes no whatever. I mean, if you're gonna do that, then
attempts to reach him have failed.
Make sure you cue in the players or like cue in some sort of information for all different characters, not just one exclusive one, especially if there's no information as to what's explained.
I need you
because Ven is not here. This cutscene is only going to be appearing in Terra and Aqua's story, I presume, since both characters are present in this cutscene.
I have unlocked the lanes between. You may use these forbidden pathways to travel between this world and countless others. The darkness looms closer than usual within these spaces, but your armor.
It's like he's pausing for a speech or something.
Remember that order must be kept. You cannot tell anyone there are other worlds.
Well, Ventus is gonna. Okay.
Fulfill your duty.
Yes, Master.
Terra, consider this an opportunity. A second chance for you to change.
Maybe this cutscene played during Ventus' story and I didn't pay attention. I don't know.
You must know. I care for you like my own son. If I could have my way, I would name you master in a second. But how can I when you are so obsessed with power?
That is very similar to his playstyle as well. He's more strength and brute heavy rather than balanced. Like, even Ventus is somehow more balanced than he is.
An obsession with power. An obsession beckons the darkness. You must never forget.
Thank you, Master.
At least he understands, right?
I will not fail you again.
That's also gonna be another problem if I don't know how long the cutscenes are, because right now we're 10 minutes in. I might have to take a break. This is usually a really quick break, as like a really quick. Oh, I could just skip this part. You forge a D-Link with it. Oh yeah, D-Links. So it's not just Ventus has having it. All characters have it, I presume. So D-Link with Aqua. So Terra has a D-Link with both Aqua and Ventus, and I'm assuming if I play Aqua, she's gonna have a D-Link with Roxas. Again, like people are also complaining, it's like, oh, it's so obviously not Roxas, but dude, they look fucking same. Like, maybe I didn't play all the other Kingdom Hearts games to understand. Oh, that's probably not actually Roxas at all, but no. If you're gonna confuse new players about whether or not which character they are, why make them the same character? Well, I guess if you're making them the same character, then you're fulfilling your purpose, right? Anyway, so Enchanted Dominion. This is not Snow White's world, is it? I don't know. This is Snow. Oh, fuck me, really? Wait a minute. Oh, so that's why some of the worlds are locked. You don't actually go. So despite technically us going here first and that being the first level, because I remember the recommend, because I think there was like two options and the recommended levels was this one was like easier than the other one. So it's definitely recommended for us to go this one first. But apparently in that cutscene during the Snow White's world, during Ventus' story, Terra was here first. So what, he was like doing whatever the fuck he was doing here real quickly, and then he's like, oh, this is getting real confusing. Actually, I don't remember. Is this Cinderella's world, or is this, is that Snow White? I don't fucking remember. I could have sworn this was Snow White's world. There's a house? This looks like the castle from, I don't fucking know anymore. What about this world? What is this? Oh, there's a castle, so I'm assuming that could be a potential Cinderella world as well. I don't fucking know. Anyways, we'll make our decision after the break. Unfortunately, we have to cut this episode, like each part a lot more shorter than usual. Unless you constantly want me to remind you guys, this episode is gonna be on my second channel because it's like, what, 3 seconds over the 15 minute time limit. Goddamn. So, sorry about that. Again, blame fucking some Australian prick who can't tell fair use and all that shit. Anyway, so be right back and stay tuned for the next episode of Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep.